Have you ever played a game that had all the right moves but no soul? Welcome to Trespassers, the ironically named game that regularly vandalizes other developers' properties. But is this on purpose or just a product of a market so heavily saturated that it's breaking under its own bloated weight? Hell, I don't know, man. I just play games. Broforce, minus the destruction, is a game that starts off with a graciously short yet obligatory tutorial stage where you zipping around in your vehicle to the next location while dishing out unenthusiastic lead burritos into the even less enthusiastic malls of the Walking Dread. I really want to love the art style as I load into the first real level, but it all just feels so been there, done that. Again, this sort of breaks my heart because that's really not the dev's fault, but just the side effect of the current gaming environment, especially on Steam where there are more games released each day than I have fears for the future of this channel. We quickly discovered that Mario was missing, from this game at least, but he sure as heck would feel right at home, with gold coins dropping from everything and anything. I also quickly discovered that I was trapped on the screen with no movement possible to the left or the right of my current location. Yeah, a lot of stages are indeed that, a singular screen where you chew gum and kick assumptions of side-scrolling right out the window. You could charge your weapon, but really it's just an exercise in suicide, as the time to charge is long and the range of your weapon is worse than the pilot of the Millennium Falcon. Your main weapon's range is so low that you'll find yourself having to get far too close to some of the bigger baddies in the game and lose that precious health that you so desperately are holding on to. The first mission has you protecting a pallet full of beer kegs, because alcoholism is one hell of a motivator, I guess. And if you survive the drab onslaught of creepy crawlies for long enough, you are offered the choice of 1 to 3 temporary upgrades. Yet again, quantity over quality rears its ugly head as this mechanic has become so overplayed that I was neither surprised nor delighted by its occurrence. On top of that, I found most of the upgrades in the game to be totally uninspired, uninteresting, and unexciting. I Am the Alcoholic Hero has so much borrowed from other games that the name Trespasser is starting to feel less and less ironic and more like a bad joke. The missions only last 5 to 10 minutes, and it's shocking how that felt way too long, as each stage begins to overstay its welcome at just the 2 to 3 minute mark. The game also has this way of feeling like a dirty mobile title, and I don't mean that it has risque content or anything like that. It just feels like it was designed to nickel and dime you for every little thing. And that's impressive, as there's no microtransactions to speak of here. Thank goodness for small favors, I suppose. It just feels off. After you complete the stage, it's back to the ripoff that is Zombie Driver opposite of HD Edition. I couldn't be bothered here to do anything but race from A to B as fast as possible, as this part of the game held all the excitement and joy of a surprise midnight visit from the local dentist who's been sampling too much of his own laughing gas and has poorly decided to liberate your mouth of those pesky things you call teeth. The puns in this game actually caused me physical discomfort as well, with names like Andy's Apocashop. What the hell does that even mean? I mean, I get it. It's apocalypse, cash, and shop combined. But I also understand that Kylo Ren is supposed to be this great evil and the grandson of the great Darth Vader. That doesn't make him come across any less like a spoiled teenager in need of a beating, hug, and nap. Not necessarily in that order. Where was I? Oh yeah, Tree Sappers, the Canadian edition, is an exercise in exercise. You know that thing you probably avoid like the plague? It feels more like a chore than a game most of the time, and it's about as much fun as playing the original Donkey Kong on an old tube TV while seasick on a sinking boat in the middle of the Arctic Sea. You may be saying to yourself at this point, "Well, Jay, now you're just too choosy. You're one of those gamers that just can't be pleased no matter what." Yeah, I'm the same guy that just raved about a game where you sit in a hallway and shoot bugs for 25 levels, then move your gun to a different hallway and do it again. Now, is there fun to be had here? I don't know. Moving on. But what about the upgrades, you may ask? To that I reply, there is indeed one upgrade that I really did like. In particular, I loved the upgrade where you got to close this game, open a different game that you actually enjoy and has originality, and play that. So, yeah, there's that at least. Have I been too hard on this game? No. The game then proceeds to take all this uninspired, boring crap and throw it all into a blender and toss you in after it. The game levels get so needlessly chaotic and bogged down that the microscopic amount of enjoyment that I was working so hard to find was utterly obliterated in short order. The game becomes so hard that it actually becomes an enigma of action-packed while boring and frustrating all at the same time. So in closing, how do I feel about T-Swappers the Golfing? It's aight. Look, guys, it's really hard to make a good game these days with every idea and art style being used more than Buzz Lightyear's catchphrase. And I know that a lot of effort went into making this, but what we have here really is just the game I'm the Hero style art with Broforce movement and feel, not as good, mind you, with Super Meat Boy sections to boot. There was also issues that I had where sometimes the controller would not work for certain commands and I'd have to revert to the keyboard, or that the very annoying and forgettable music would get oddly soft at times. Or that the screen would stay locked higher than where my character was, like the camera was stuck for a minute before it decided to catch up. At the end of the day, you'll buy this game based off of if it looks fun to you or not. And I do think that there's a niche group of players that might enjoy this game at times for a short period. Teresa Passers is a game that will not be remembered for very long, if at all, due to the fact that there's over a dozen games that do every part of this game better and more memorably. Well, before Animal Rights gets after me for beating a dead horse, I better make like the game Banana Island and flop. I appreciate all of you guys stopping by, and I look forward to seeing all of you on the next episode of E-Electric Productions.